What was the moment you realized that you shouldn't have showed up to a date? I was 18. A girl sent me a message saying she got my details from my mate and wanted to go on a date with me. I asked my mate and he said she was hot. So after talking a bit I agreed to a date. I had seen a photo and she was attractive. I turned up to the cafe for the date and was approached by some girl I'd never seen with a baby. She then told me she was the girl, looked nothing like her photo. She explained she thought I'd never go for someone who looked like her. She was right. Then she left her baby with me while she went to the toilet quickly. Alarm bells started to ring after 15 minutes. I asked a waitress to check on her. To my surprise, the waitress came back and said no one was in there. I looked around the cafe and she was gone. I hadn't noticed her leaving. I didn't have any of her contact details and smartphones were not a thing, so I didn't have internet access. I phoned my mate and got him to attempt to contact her on MSN. After telling him what happened, he was surprised and had no idea. Apparently he also thought her pictures were the real her. Another 20 minutes went and I was scared, so I asked the waitress for help. Thankfully she was able to help and called the police. They showed up and I explained what happened. I didn't know anything about this girl, so I couldn't really help them. They said if she contacted me to get her to contact them. I left and walked towards my car. I went past another cafe about 6 shops down and there she was with a different guy. I went back to the police and got them to take her baby in while I watched through the window outside and waved when she looked up. Turns out I was the babysitter for her real date. He told me to meet him at a bar, which turned out to be a hole in the wall in a strip mall. Literally just a bar. No food, just booze. We were supposed to be having dinner. I had put in some effort with a cute outfit, nice makeup, etc. He showed up in ratty old jeans and a paint-splattered hoodie. That was the moment that made me think, oh, this is gonna be bad. But he'd already caught me. So we sat down, and the bartender immediately put a pint glass vodka tonic in front of him before even asking what I wanted. Clearly he was a regular. We tried to make small talk, but he was just so weird. He was cutting me off mid-sentence with random nonsense, buddy punching me on the arm, and kept hurrying me to finish my drink so I could keep up with him. He was slamming these pints of vodka tonic one after the other, and the bartender kept them coming. I finished my one light beer, paid for my drink, which offended him deeply, and got up to leave. He chugged his last drink, threw a $100 bill on the bar, and followed me into the parking lot. I tried to get away politely, and he interrupted with, "Come back to my place." I stumbled over my R, "No thank you," and before I'd finished the sentence he got into his car, started the engine, and screeched out of the parking lot, almost getting it on two wheels on the turn. There were some interesting characters back in the early days of online dating. 2004 was like the Wild West. I dated this girl who was a friend of a friend. She used to come into the pub I worked at for $10 steak night with her mum, and a guy who we weren't sure if was her boyfriend or brother. Turned out it was her brother, but they were weirdly close. Anyway, we went on a date. She seemed quite uncomfortable the whole time. Didn't make much conversation. Just obviously wasn't into it. So I dropped her home, and she asked me if I wanted to come in. Against my better judgment I did. They had 2 couches in the living room. I sat on one awkwardly, while she laid on the other couch, and spooned with her brother. At this point I realized I should not have shown up. Every time she left the pub from then on in her and her brother left holding hands. When she responded to hi on Tinder with something like, "Hey cutie, want to come to my parents' house?" Not really a date, honestly, but a good story. We chatted for a bit, and according to her she wasn't looking for anything serious, but she wanted me to pick her up, take her out to dinner, and maybe have intimate time afterwards. Very transactional, which kinda stung, but whatever, she was hot. I looked up the address she gave me, and was surprised to find a neighborhood I did work in, and that the house was one I knew was for sale. Specifically, the owner died, and it was being gutted to be resold by his kids. At this point 100% convinced this was a scam, but somewhat curious, I decided to drive by and see if anyone was there, texting her I was coming, but in a different type of car. Really expensive neighborhood, on a sea cliff. Felt like an adventure. Took my work truck, drove by, and some huge dude comes out of the house, stares at my truck, and goes back in. could see other people inside, noped out of there super fast, pretty convinced it was a phishing scam to mug me or a prank, didn't feel like finding out. When the guy that showed up was easily 30 years older than what he looked like in the picture he had sent me. This happened to me once, except it was with a house cleaner. I hired him cause he asked me to online. I thought he was 50. He came out of the car hobbling and couldn't carry his cleaning stuff up my stairs. His daughter called and he had her on speaker. She was screaming saying an 80-year-old man shouldn't be cleaning people houses. He did such a horrible job cleaning my house. He also left the gas stove running, and if I hadn't noticed the smell, we probably would've blown up. Lol, I felt so bad I panic tipped him $30. When he asked me out, and I said yes, he then asked if I'd like to go to dinner, and what kind of food I liked. I said anything but sushi. He took me to a sushi place, said he thought he'd be able to change my mind. I showed up, and her best friend was there, that I hadn't been warned, was coming with us. Then her brother showed up, then her dad showed up, then her mom and her three cousins aged 3 to 5 showed up. That was the point I excused myself to bathroom. Thankfully this is one of those places where the employees will sneak you out if you're having a bad date and need an out, and apparently I'm the first guy they snuck out at that point. When I went on this date with this dude, and he had zero interests. When I tell you zero, I mean it. He didn't watch movies, series, did not listen to music, did not watch TV, didn't have any hobbies, did not have any siblings, any friends, any work, just university studies. He didn't like to cook, or clean, or even go on walks. It was the most awkward date I have ever been with someone. I went on a date a few months after me and my college girlfriend had broken up. I had matched with this girl off of Tinder and we messaged a bit, but she was relentless about wanting to know more about my ex and how I felt after the breakup. I looked past this and met her for dinner a couple nights later. I walked in the restaurant and my ex is sitting at the table under that girl's name. I turned around to walk out and got a Tinder notification from the girl I had agreed to meet. You'll never be able to get away from me. Should have stayed home that night and steer clear of blind dates. I went on a date with a guy on Tinder. He was a co-worker of one of my friends, so I figured he'd be alright. First date was decent enough, so we went on a second. This date was also going well until I mentioned his pentagram necklace, asking if he just liked the design or if he was pagan. He either did not wear this necklace to the first date, or it had been under his shirt. He replied pagan, and I said how I found the pagan religion to be very interesting, and was hoping to hear more about it. Oh boy, I wish I didn't. He had been fairly shy up until that point. He did a complete 180, and started going on, very loudly in this fairly nice restaurant, about how his mother could physically heal people just with touch, and about how his friend was in the army, and got shot in the leg, but didn't feel any pain from it, because my date had linked minds with him from across the world, and took all the pain for him instead. I managed to get through the date, and when I got home, I messaged to say it wasn't working out, that I didn't feel any spark after two dates, and wished him well. He immediately blocked me. I then messaged my friend, who was his co-worker, asking if the pagan talk was normal for him. Friend calls me to cry from laughter over the phone about how he and all the other co-workers knew he was crazy, but also knew he was harmless, so wanted to see how I'd react to him. Bit cruel on my friend's part to not warn me, especially since he knew I was going on these dates, but I definitely wasn't going on a third regardless. Meet a girl at a bar and things clicked well. Went on a date a few nights later, and she shows up with her sister. I didn't think anything of it at the time. Figured she was being safe possibly, since we just met, but this happened 2 more times. I finally said, "Can we go out without your sister?" and she seemed insulted at the idea. Found out months later she had no sister. It was just her friend and they did everything together. Was truly strange. I waited on the park bench next to a girl for about 30 minutes after the agreed upon time. Turns out I was sitting next to my date the entire time. I just didn't recognize her, because she was at least 200 pounds bigger than any of her pictures with no similarities. Turns out her much more attractive friend was trying to help her out, by making a Tinder profile, using her own pictures, doing the matching and flirting, and then letting her less attractive friend actually do the meetings. Dating is actually crazy. I went to his house to play magic after meeting him at my LGS a couple times, excused myself to pee, and as I was peeing, he stood outside of the bathroom door and did an awful impression of the Joker laugh while saying he's been waiting for someone like me and other extremely creepy phrases about how I'm perfect for him. The post-peeing bathroom exit was so absolutely awkward, riddled with me saying several different versions of "oh wow, that was a great Joker impression haha" and him continuing to speak like the Joker. It was the longest, most tense, fearful walk down the stairs. I left shortly after that. It still scares me. I'm not sure what was the exact moment I realized I shouldn't have showed up, but I think it was at some point during the first 10 minutes. She showed up 30 minutes late and her apology was back quote, "sorry I'm late, but I'm always late." Then she spent the first 15 minutes talking about her ex who she just broke up with 3 days ago. During the entire date, she asked zero questions about me and only talked about herself and her problems, gossiped about her friends, who I didn't even know at all, spent 20 minutes showing me photos and videos of her cat. I usually like cats, but I was really annoyed at that point, complained about the ice in her soda, and spent the last 10 minutes of the date talking about how much she needs to pee, but refused to use the public restroom. I was so glad when that date was over. I met this guy on Tinder. He seemed really cool. We started texting for a month or so and later planned to meet at this tavern. It was hard trying to find him because the place was packed. When I do see him, I guess he's drunk. Lol, but he didn't seem like completely out of it. He was functional. I tried to ask him questions and get to know him in this sort of loud and busy space, and the whole time, even though he's inches away from my face, he can't hear what I'm asking or saying. Mind you, he invited me to this place. I'd never gone here before. This was supposed to be our first date. He proceeds to buy me a beer and kept slapping me on my backside quite forcefully, to be honest. This is my first time meeting him. We get a beer and he asks me, "Do you want a drink?" I tell him he just bought me one. He asks this question annoyingly over and over again, as if he forgot he asks. This goes on for at least an hour, all the while I'm trying to kick it with him, play some outdoor bar games and such, and he's asking, "What are you doing here?" And I'm like, "I'm on a date with you, lol." He asks me this question over and over as well. I don't get how anyone is that incoherent. He wasn't that drunk, couldn't have been. Even if he was, when we texted he seemed fairly intelligible and kind. But the whole night he probably only asked me 2 to 3 questions, the same ones, over and over, and kept slapping me on my backside. There was a point we were going to congregate with his friends, and I sort of lost him in the crowd and left. Very rude and weird. He had the nerve to call me and asked where I went. I told him I went home. He said he wanted to get to know me, and I was like, "Yeah, maybe another time." Like, dude, you had the whole night to try. He had no intent to make a real effort. I blocked him. Took a weird interest in me working in childcare. Kept bringing up kids and toddlers. Eventually he made it clear he wanted a lot of kids and wanted me at home taking care of them. Which, whatever, I like the idea of being a housewife. Just the way he came across was bad and misogynistic. Told me at one point he's not touching the kids till they're out of diapers. That's my job. At that point I knew I had made a mistake. Problem was, he was also my ride, since a friend dropped me off, had to go home with him. When she asked if we could stop at her mom's house first, so she could grab something, then after 10 minutes of waiting in the car she came running out of the door carrying a baby and a woman was chasing her screaming. She jumped in the car and started yelling, "Drive, drive, drive." I turned the car off and got out. This happened to a friend of mine. He had recently broken up with a long-term girl and was looking to get back out there, but was too cheap to pay for a dating service, so stuck to free ones. He sets up a date with a girl to come over to his place and do some hot tubbing. She shows up and wants some specific kind of alcohol, I'll say Goldschläger, which he didn't have, so she insists they make a liquor store run. She seemed sketchy, so my buddy is about 50% sure he's going to get robbed. So he tells her to drive and deliberately forgets his wallet and phone at home. When he gets in her car, there's no passenger seat. She said she has a huge dog, so she took the seat out. He has to sit in the back seat. The date was late, so the closest liquor store is closed. Rather than go back to his place, She says she knows a liquor store that's open late point. He says they're all state stores. They all close the same time point. She won't listen, and they hit the highway. After a while, he starts to wonder where they are going, and says, "Where is this store?" And she screams. She had forgotten he was in the car, because he was in the back seat. My buddy now accepts that she is already drunk. She won't stop or pull over to let him drive. Just keeps driving. Turns out the late liquor store is about 30 minutes from his house, and she forgets he was in the car twice more on the trip. They get to the store, and it's closed, as expected. She gets out anyway, and is doing the jerking the locked door thing and yelling hello, over and over. My buddy is out of the car watching this as she starts yelling at some sketchy looking dudes drinking 40s in the parking lot. Starts with "Why is this store closed?" and quickly escalates to racial slurs and profanity. My buddy takes this as his opportunity and just walks away, doesn't even look back. Now he finds himself 30 minute drive from home, with no wallet or cell phone, because he was so smart. He eventually gets a convenience store clerk to take pity on him, and he called his brother to come pick him up. He said he was worried about the chick showing up at his house, but he never heard from her again. One of my first attempts at online dating many years ago, the girl wasn't very bright, but she was really nice and absolutely beautiful judging by the pictures she'd sent me. As a little background, she told me she was 5 feet 2 and worked out, and had an average to slim body. I didn't think anything of her telling me her height, because she asked me mine. And that's not always easily deduced from photos, but her telling me that she worked out and had an average slash slim body was odd, because that was clear from the photos. After a couple weeks, we set a time and place to meet. I arrived at a park near a gazebo she said she would be at. I looked through my windshield, but all I saw was this really tall, obese woman wearing pajamas standing inside. She was easily 6 feet 4 inches or 6 feet 5 inches, certainly taller than I was. Thought maybe she was late, because clearly there was number 5 feet 2 inches petite female in sight. So I call her. Then I see the woman's flip phone light up and play a song I didn't recognize, and she answered. It was her. She said, "I see you." Immediately hung up and started walking towards my car. That was the moment I knew I'd wasted an hour of my time driving out to meet a stranger. I hit the lock before she could open door and rolled down the window with a "Do I know you?" She said something along the lines of "Yeah, I'm a bit taller than I said." I apologized, said I had to go, and I pulled away. Tall obese women have never been my type, but even if they were, starting out any relationship on an easily verified lie is a gigantic red flag. She texted me a minute or so later and told me it was strange of me to make her get ready to go out, just to leave her hanging. Her version of getting ready was putting on old unwashed pajamas. I ended up hanging out with some friends I hadn't seen in years, that happened to live 20 minutes away, so it wasn't a total loss. Bullet dodged, nonetheless.